senior citizens, our elders, the children of our homes, caregivers, the management of the residential homes, the LICI representative here this morning, Mr. Akhilesh, Mr. Lokesh Lal, M Science, a very good friend, representatives of Supreme Fuel. Ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning to you all. And like I said, it's time for Christmas. So once again, Merry Christmas. Thank you for coming here on such short notice to be with us on this very special day. To be with you as the minister means a lot for me. And that's why you will see that my whole team is here to celebrate Christmas lunch with you this morning. We will make sure that this is not the first and the last. We have made a commitment. I have made a commitment since taking up office. We've started up with Diwali celebrations, and the momentum will continue throughout our four-year term. That much I can assure you. Like I said, I made a commitment that I will celebrate Christmas with my the elderly in the caregiving homes and all the children across Fiji who are in our residential home, and that's why we are here this morning. You all know that Christmas is a very special occasion. We all look forward for Christmas. And in Fiji and across the world, Christmas is celebrated by all, irrespective of race, religion, belief, age, and gender. Please allow the children to talk. It's their day. However, we believe there are some people who are not as fortunate as we are, who may not have the ability to celebrate Christmas as we do. So this is a small gesture on our part. The Ministry for Women, Children and Social Welfare, with our very kind sponsors for today's lunch. And at this point, if we can put our hands together for Supreme Fuel, Amin's Insurance, Mr. Anil Amin, thank you very much. Dr. Sood, all the way from Bar, Dr. Gohil from Bar, and of course, our partners from LICI, we have our representative here. I will not forget Mr. Lokesh once again for the initiative and enthusiasm he showed when we approached him. I believe this is a generous part on him to talk to other stakeholders to make this Christmas lunch and celebration a success. And on a special note, I would like to remember my colleague, the Minister for Tourism and Trade, Mr. Fayaz Koya, for his contributions as well. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the very reason that we have a special day like this at the Sugar City. Coming from the West, I know how the people of West like to celebrate. And coming from Bar, I know the friends in Lautoka share the same sentiments. And I'm sure the people of Lautoka are also as sweet as the city is called the Sugar City. Well, I have to say this because we have other celebrations coming up as well. Being secluded and uncared for are matters that the state exists to eliminate, and in my ministry and other social sectors of the Fijian government. If the shoulders that you should have leaned on are no longer with us, or people have abandoned you for some reasons, let me assure you that the ministry and the government, with the goodwill of the community, will support you at all times. Your family may have abandoned you. Your children may have abandoned you. Your parents, children may have abandoned you, but if you look around us, you see faces that are here to protect you. And I can give you my word that the Fijian government is committed to looking after the disadvantaged, children and the elderly all across Fiji. To our senior citizens, the Fijian government cares for you. And like I said, we will continue to do so in the years to come. We want you to feel special as you have contributed a lot to our lives and to the country as a whole. For reasons best known to your families, if your children have disregarded you, let it be. Please be assured that you will get all our love and attention. To our respectable elders, let me assure you that even the law protects your interest. The Fijian government assures you that we will provide the means to see that you age with respect, dignity, and trust. Ladies and gentlemen, the Bill of Rights in Fiji recently accented in the 2013 Constitution and has for the first time in the history of the nation, in response to the strong wishes of people, the Constitution provides for a wide range of socio-economic rights. And of course, it's a privilege being the Minister for Children. I am delighted to embrace the holistic environment to nurture our child. It means embarking on new partnerships and endeavors so that the best interests of the child are preserved. My message to Fiji would be to love your children, care for them, and please take out time for them. Their education holds the key to the future and the life out of any forms of dependency and disadvantages. The government, the Fijian government, holds self-reliance as a key outcome in our new democracy. To all the stakeholders that have supported us to host this celebration, I thank you from the bottom of my heart for the compassion and goodwill that you have shown at such a short notice. The joy that you see on the faces of our elderly, our disabled, and our children cannot be measured in terms of any monetary gain. The joy of the children, the older persons, and disadvantaged here today do touch all our hearts in a way which is indescribable. I encourage all others to come on board to support the ministry in such initiatives to light up the lives of those underprivileged in our society. Like I said, we have a lot of members in our society who are not as privileged, who are not as fortunate to have what we have within our means. And being Christmas, I'm sure the message is to brighten up somebody else's life. So look around you, look at your neighbors, look at your families around you, look at those children who do not have any support. Please go out off your way this Christmas to make their lives more happier and more merrier. Your contributions, all our sponsors and stakeholders, have put a smile on the face of our beloved ones here today. Do take this time to meet the children in our homes. Do take this time to meet the elderly and our disabled that are here. Unfortunately, we have some members of our homes who could not make it up to this function, but we will be visiting them after this lunch. Sometimes the biggest of the worries goes away when you give a comforting touch, even a smile. A smile sometimes means a lot. We are so busy, sometimes we get so busy in our own lives that we forget that the person sitting next to us may be having some problems and issues. This Christmas, please take some time out to understand your neighbors. We need to live in a society that has a caring heart at all times, not only during Christmas and Diwali and birthdays and New Year's. Life goes on 365 days a year. So it's not only during this festive season that we need to remember the disadvantaged. Okay? Not only that, but to respond with the means of support for the well-being of people in times of despair. Many a times we try to turn a blind eye. We know a problem exists and we think it is not our business. Okay? Let us get rid of that mindset. And I do hope the little gifts and the meal that is specially prepared for you children and the elders will be of your satisfaction. And like I said, take it from me, this will not be the last of such happy moments. To families who may be listening in, take care of your elders. Please do not abandon your children and the disadvantaged members of our community. To my team of caregivers and the management of the residential home, I urge you to do your responsibilities with utmost honesty. With utmost honesty. When I say honesty, I mean you are entrusted with the lives of the disadvantaged. You are entrusted with the lives of day-old babies at time. And I'm sure, this Christmas would be a good time for you to go back and reflect on your role as caregivers. You become the parents of these children in our homes. The way you're going to mold them, that's how their future is going to be. Please do your duty with utmost honesty and integrity. And on this note, I once again thank all our stakeholders and sponsors and wish you a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.